Does it make the boat go faster? That's the only question. Life leaks, right? Those are holes in the boat, okay? And those need to be plugged up. Diet, sleep, exercise. You're not doing those things, you're not on point on those things, your boat is going slower. You're getting to your goal slower, okay? And if you know from my last video, the secret for energy, the secret for being motivated, the secret for being excited to wake up, is passion for what you're doing in progress. Okay, you need to be in the right vehicle for maximizing your talents, man. If real estate's not the right vehicle, then it's insurance, or it's coaching, or it's personal training, whatever it is, you know, that's going to be able to get you that seven figure take home, man. Not revenue, seven figure take home. You got to be passionate about it. And the other thing, okay, it's passion plus progress. The faster you're accomplishing things, the more excited, the more energy you're gonna get. The faster the boat goes, the better you feel. The slower the boat goes, the worse you feel. And usually in the initial stages of building a business, that boat's going slow, man. So you need to do everything to plug up the holes, okay? A rookie entrepreneur's boat is fucking no horsepower and full of holes. He's doing all kinds of things wrong. Most people's businesses are boats that are filled with holes, not hose. Some people, Dan Bilzerian's boat is filled with hose. Most people's boats are filled with holes and they've got a terrible motor. Okay, 90% of businesses fail. The ones that succeed, something like 70% of them make less than 100 grand a year. Okay, and those boats are going slow. So the holes in the boat. You're talking about if you're not getting enough sleep, your energy is going to be shit. Your boat's going to be going slowly. If you're not exercising, your energy is going to be slow. Your boat's going to go slow. If you're not on point with your diet, I'll admit I'm definitely not 100% on point. I don't get fat, but I don't eat healthy 100% of the time. But I eat healthy enough at least during the day, okay, to have energy. And that's super important. So you got to plug those holes up, okay? The other thing you have to do is get rid of the dead weight. Wrong partner, wrong life partner, wrong business partner, wrong friendships, wrong employees. They've got to go, and you've got to be ruthless with that because if you don't sacrifice those people, your dreams are going to get sacrificed. Okay, let me say that to you again. If you're not sacrificing those relationships on the altar of success, your success and your dreams are going to be sacrificed. That's how it works. You've got to get rid of people that are slowing the boat down, and you've got to have no mercy for it. And people aren't going to like you for it. Some people will think you're a dick. You know what? They were in the way, had to be sacrificed. And you have to get good at this, and you have to be ruthless with this. You look at any successful person, they get rid of dead weight. And the more successful they are, the faster they do it. Okay? I'm not saying being rude about it. I'm not saying being aggressive about it. I'm saying being matter of fact about it and recognize you're either committed to your success or you're not. Okay? If you're committed to your success, you've got to plug up those leaks and you got to get rid of dead weight on the fucking boat. It's super important. All right? So those are two things that you need to do. The third thing that you need to do is you need to focus on the engine, on the horsepower. Okay? I really only do three things now. I've got rid of the bulk of what I used to do. I've got rid of the bulk of the dumbass projects that I spent time doing. Okay? And I've been in doing art at least since 2012. Most of you guys only know me from YouTube. I've been writing articles since 2012. 9 out of 10, on average, 9 out of 10 of the projects that I've done were worthless. Like newsletter projects, near worthless. You know, Twitter, worthless. LinkedIn, worthless. Okay? There's enough room on YouTube to only do that and my website and not even touch the ceiling in the entirety of my life. Okay? This is the reality. So focusing on what's the most profitable thing and doing that at all times and trying to only do things that are profitable. Okay? So let's say, you know, the speed of the boat is measured by revenue. You can either choose revenue or profit, whatever. So what's going to get you to your revenue targets as fast as possible? You know, or how do you 2, 3, 4x your revenue next year, right? You do things that only make the boat go faster. You focus on the engine and you focus on, upgrading that boat, making it lighter, making it leaner. The offensive projects. The defensive projects are less fun. It's not fun to plug up leaks in your dye. It's not fun to, make sure you're in bed by 10 o'clock. Okay, it's not fun to get rid of people or to have to fire an employee unless you're some kind of a sociopath. Normal people don't like doing those things. Those are necessities. Okay, when those are done, though, you get to focus on the fun stuff, on the offense. So basically, all I do now is put out content like this, service my existing clients, and close new clients. Okay. The other thing I'm working on is courses, but I've got 17 courses. I've got so much content. A lot of this is because I actually write stuff, or I did write stuff in the past, and it's applicable. And I need someone who I need help on those courses. Okay, so if you know anyone who can help me with that, hit me up, a link in the comment section there. But primarily for at least the rest of this year, it's just courses, or sorry, content, servicing my existing clients and closing new clients. All right, and I'm in the process of retooling my coaching offer. I'm going to be getting on the phone, closing deals. Just like in my other business, every Tuesday we're closing $10,000 deals for one of our clients there. I'm going to set up a similar model for my deal. And maximize what's probably still my most profitable skill, which is sales, with the exception of my skill in content marketing, organic content marketing. Okay. I'm also outsourcing the paid marketing, doing that, which I hadn't done before. Okay, that's gonna make the boat go faster. And then if I can find someone who I can outsource the organization of a lot of my materials for my courses, I'll put money into that. Okay, but still, the bulk of my time is going to be closing those new deals that come in, servicing my clients, doing the content, because those are things that only I can do until perhaps I master that close and then train up my business partner to be able to do that for me. And then all I'll be doing is content creation and servicing clients and having a full day of servicing clients, all of which I like, by the way.